Hi viewers, welcome to Inverse Dark ID News. Today headlines.
Health Minister includes sudden loss of smell and taste in list of coronavirus symptoms. People who streets in Kathmandu to protest against new map. One dead, 15 injuries in Rawalpindi blast. New Nepal map could seal dialogue with India, say officials. Chinese diplomat tweets a twist to Ladakh standoff sees link to Article 370.
Today news.
The Union Health Ministry on Saturday enhanced the list of symptoms of novel coronavirus and included sudden loss of smell and taste to the list. In the new clinical guidelines issued by the ministry, loss of smell, anosmia, or loss of taste, agesia, preceding the onset of respiratory symptoms has been added. The question of whether these should be recognized as symptoms of COVID-19 was reportedly discussed in a meeting of the National Task Force on COVID-19 that was held last Sunday. The new map proposed in Nepal Parliament today, Saturday. Many areas of India have also been included in this map. Since Saturday morning, people in Kathmandu are taking to the streets to protest against this map. Earlier on Friday, too many protesters took to the road against the government. After which Nepal's Foreign Minister Pradeep Gyawali on Friday night requested the media to stop showing the demonstration. The Foreign Minister of Nepal has told that, on Saturday, i.e. today, a historic bill will be decided by the country's parliament. One person was killed and 15 others were injured when explosives attached to an electricity pole in Pakistan's Rawalpindi city went off, police said. A big fire erupted after the powerful blast on Friday night in the city's Sada Bazaar, which also caused widespread damage at the scene, reports the Express Tribune. According to the police, the victim was a vendor who used to sell vegetables near the pole where the blast occurred. India says that the parliamentary approval of the Nepal map will seal dialogue with the neighboring nation. Nepal's parliament will hold a special meeting on Saturday to complete voting on the new political map that redraws its border with India. Officials tell One India that there would not be any harsh statements, as it is more important to settle the issue rather than worsening it. India has reminded Nepal about the friendly relations it shared and has repeatedly stated that on the map, it has made its position clear. The spokesman of the Chinese embassy in Pakistan created a flutter in diplomatic circles by appearing to suggest the standoff between Indian and Chinese border troops was linked to New Delhi's decision to scrap Jammu and Kashmir's special status last year. Wang Jianfeng, whose Twitter bio describes him as press officer at the Chinese mission in Islamabad, included in his tweet a link to an article by a scholar from an influential think tank affiliated with China's Ministry of State Security or main intelligence agency, which also suggested a connection between the border tensions and the change in Kashmir's status.
Thanks for watching. Like, share, comment, subscribe to Inverse Dark and activate bell icon.